Today I'll be discussing the differences between an LLC and an LCC topology and how our new UCC 25660 is a game changer. The LLC topology is named after its resonant tank. This means there are two inductive elements and one capacitive element, hence the term LLC. The LCC topology is also named after its resonant tank. This means that there is one inductive element and two capacitive elements, hence the term LCC. There are three requirements for resonance. One of them is to have an inductive input impedance. The inductive elements ensure a lagging current, which can help ensure current flows through the body diode of the switching element to help achieve ZVS or zero voltage switching. The second requirement for resonance is there has to be sufficient energy stored in the resonant tank. There has to be more energy in the tank than the output capacitance or COSS of the switch network. This means 1/2 Li squared has to be greater than 1/2 CV squared. Last but not least, there has to be sufficient dead time. This has to be long enough where both switches are off to discharge the energy in the switch network. So what are the differences between an LLC and an LCC? The LCC topology works between two resonant frequencies. FR1 is the minimum frequency, and FR2 is the maximum resonant frequency. The LCC topology works above a minimum frequency. This makes it much more suitable for applications that require wider output voltages, such as battery charging and LED lighting. So why not just stick with an LCC topology? Well, first and foremost, the LLC topology is actually much more efficient. Let's compare two topologies assuming the same 400 volt input voltage. Two things stand out. The LCC input RMS currents can be more than double the LLC topology. This higher input current increases the I2R losses. The LLC switching frequency has more variation than the LCC. This variation impacts the control loop and makes it harder to control when it goes into burst mode or into overload power protection. The new UCC 25660 makes the choice easier because it introduces a new concept called IPPC, or input power proportional control. This removes the dependence on the switching frequency from the control voltage. For lighting, this helps to avoid entering burst mode for deep dimming. Here you can see a comparison between IPPC and traditional hybrid hysteretic control. This is at the same power level, but you can see as the V out changes, hybrid hysteretic control may enter burst mode at the lower voltage level, whereas IPPC has a relatively flat control voltage. For battery charging, IPPC helps to avoid entering burst mode when VBAT is low and the charging current is high. This goes a long way in preventing battery degradation. To better illustrate this, the CCCV curve here is showing traditional hybrid hysteretic control, and you can see here at the same power level of 373 watts in the CC mode versus 373 watts in the CV mode, you have a very different control voltage. This means when you have a low VBAT, it's much more difficult to avoid entering burst mode when you have the high constant current charging current. With the same battery charging profile, with IPPC control now, at the same power level, you have the same control voltage. So 373 volts in the constant current region has the same control voltage as 373 watts in a constant voltage region. This makes it much easier to avoid entering burst mode with low VBAT. Well, I hope you found this informative. Thank you for watching. Please find out more on TI.com. And look for the UCC 25660